The Yellow Emperor Huangdi, formerly romanized as Huangti and Huangti, is one of the legendary Chinese sovereigns and culture heroes included among the three sovereigns and five emperors. Tradition holds that Huangdi reigned from 2697 to 2597 or 2698 to 2598 BC. Huangdi's cult was particularly prominent in the late Warring States and early Han period, when he was portrayed as the originator of the centralized state, a cosmic ruler, and a patron of esoteric arts. Traditionally credited with numerous inventions and innovations, the Yellow Emperor is now regarded as the initiator of Chinese civilization, and said to be the ancestor of all Huaxia Chinese. Historicity. The Chinese historian Sima Qian, and much Chinese historiography following him, considered the Yellow Emperor to be a more historical figure than earlier legendary figures such as Fuxi, Nuwa, and the Yan Emperor. His records of the Grand Historian begins with the Yellow Emperor, while passing over the others. Throughout most of Chinese history, the Yellow Emperor and the other ancient sages were considered to be real historical figures. In their attempts to prove that the earliest figures of Chinese history were mythological, Gu and his followers argued that these ancient sages were originally gods who were later depicted as humans by the rationalist intellectuals of the Warring States period. Yang Quan, a member of the same historiographical current, noted that only in the Warring States period had the Yellow Emperor started to be described as the first ruler of China. Yang thus argued that Huangdi was a later transformation of Shangdi, the supreme god of the Shang pantheon. Also in the 1920s, French scholars Henri Maspero and Marcel Granet published critical studies of China's accounts of high antiquity. In his Danses et Légendes de la Chine ancienne, Dances and Legends of Ancient China, for example, Granet argued that these tales were historicized legends that said more about the time when they were written than about the time they purported to describe. Most scholars now agree that the Yellow Emperor originated in tales of the gods which later presented the character as a human. K.C. Chang sees Huangdi and other cultural heroes as ancient religious figures who were euhemerized in the late Warring States and Han periods. Historian of ancient China, Mark Edward Lewis, speaks of the Yellow Emperor's earlier nature as a god, whereas Rolsterkex, a professor at University of Cambridge, calls Huangdi a legendary cultural hero. Names. Clan names. The Yellow Emperor has been referred to as Shanyanshi and Yuzhongshi. 3rd century scholar Huang Fumi commented that Shanyuan was the name of a hill where Huangdi had lived and that he later took as a name. Qing dynasty commentator Liang Yusheng argued instead that the hill was named after the Yellow Emperor rather than the opposite. According to British sinologist Herbert Hallam Giles, Yuzhong was a name taken from Huangdi's hereditary principality. Giles also cited sources saying that Shanyuan was the name of a village where the Yellow Emperor had lived. William Nienhauser, a modern translator of the Shijia, explains that Huangdi was originally the head of the Yuzhong clan, which lived near what is now Xinzheng in Henan. The Yellow Emperor. In the late Warring States period, the Yellow Emperor was integrated into the cosmological scheme of the five phases, in which the color yellow represents earth dragons and the center. The correlation of the colors in association with different dynasties was mentioned in the Luxi Chengqiu, where the Yellow Emperor's reign was seen to be governed by earth. Origin and development of the myth. Origins. The origin of Huangdi's legend is unclear, but historians have formulated several hypotheses about it. Yang's view is based on the series Shangdi equals greater than Huang, Shangdi equals greater than Huangdi equals greater than Huangdi, in which he claims that Huang either was a graphic variant of Huang or was used as a taboo character for the latter. Yang's view has been criticized by Motari Masaru and by Michael Puett. Historian Mark Edward Lewis agrees that Huang and Huang were often interchangeable, but, disagreeing with Yang, he claims that Huang, meaning yellow, appeared first. Based on what he admits is a novel etymology, likening Huang to the phonetically close Wang, Lewis suggests that Huang, in the Yellow Emperor's title, might originally have meant rain-making shaman or rain-making ritual, citing late Warring States and early Han versions of Huangdi's myth. He further argues that the figure of the Yellow Emperor originated in ancient rain-making rituals in which the Yellow Emperor represented the power of rain and clouds, whereas his mythical rival Kaiyi stood for fire and drought. Also disagreeing with Yang Kuan's hypothesis, Sarah Allen finds it unlikely that such a popular myth as the Yellow Emperor's could have come from a taboo character. She argues instead that pre-Shang history, including the story of the Yellow Emperor, can all be understood as a later transformation and systematization of Shang myth. In her view, Huangdi was originally an unnamed lord of the underworld, the mythological counterpart of the Shang sky deity Shangdi. At the time, Shang rulers claimed that their mythical ancestors identified with the ten suns, birds, east, life, and the Lord on High, had defeated an earlier people associated with the underworld, dragons, west. After the Zhou overthrew the Shang in the 11th century BC, Zhou leaders reinterpreted Shang myths as meaning that the Shang had vanquished a real political dynasty, which was eventually named the Chia dynasty. By Han times, as seen in Sima Qian's account in the Shijia, the Yellow Emperor, who was lord of the underworld, had been symbolically linked to the Chia, had become a historical ruler whose descendants were thought to have founded the Chia. The Yellow Emperor in pre-imperial times. Accounts of the Yellow Emperor started to appear in Chinese texts in the Warring States period. The most ancient extant reference to Huangdi is an inscription on a bronze vessel made in the first half of the 4th century BC by the royal family of the state of Qi. Michael Puet writes that this was one of several references to the Yellow Emperor in the 4th and 3rd centuries BC within accounts of the creation of the state. Elements of Huangdi's myth. Early years. According to Huang Fumi, the Yellow Emperor was born in Shouqiu, which is today on the outskirts of the city of Kui in Shandong. Early on, he lived with his tribe in the northwest near the Ji River, later migrating to Duolu in modern-day Hebei. He then became a farmer and tamed six different special beasts: the bear, the brown bear, the pion Xiu, which later combined to form the mythical Pixiu, the ferocious Chu, and the tiger. From this, Yi Shuxian associated the Yellow Emperor with bear legends common across Northeast Asia people, as well as the Dangun legend. The Yellow Emperor and the Yan Emperor were both leaders of a tribe or a combination of two tribes near the Yellow River. In an era that modern Chinese history books often refer to as primitive society, the Yan Emperor hailed from a different area around the Jiang River. Throne rooms, the Bosling, early Chinese astronomy, the Chinese calendar, math calculations, code of sound laws, and Qiju, an early Chinese version of football. He is also sometimes said to have been partially responsible for the invention of the Guqin zither. Although others credit the Yan Emperor with inventing instruments for Ling Lun's compositions, in traditional accounts, he also goads the historian Kang Ji into creating the first Chinese character writing system, the Oracle Bone Script, and his principal wife, Li Zhi, invents sericulture and teaches his people how to weave silk and dye clothes. At one point in his reign, the Yellow Emperor allegedly visited the mythical East Sea and met a talking beast called the Baizai, who taught him the knowledge of all supernatural creatures. This beast explained to him there were 11,522 kinds of supernatural creatures. Battles. According to traditional accounts, the Yan Emperor meets the force of the Nine Li under their bronze-headed leader, Kai Yu, and his 81 horned and four-eyed brothers and suffers a decisive defeat. He flees to Duolu and begs the Yellow Emperor for help. During the ensuing Battle of Duolu, the Yellow Emperor employs his tamed animals and Kai darkens the sky by breathing out of thick fog. This leads the Emperor to develop the self-pointing chariot, which he uses to lead his army out of the miasma. He next calls upon the drought demon Nuba to dispel Caillou's storm. He then destroys the Ninely and defeats Caillou before falling out with the Yan Emperor, defeating him at Banquan and replacing him as the primary ruler. Death. The Yellow Emperor was said to have lived for over 100 years before meeting a phoenix and a Qi Ling and then dying. Two tombs were built in Shaanxi within the mausoleum of the Yellow Emperor, in addition to others in Henan, Hebei and Gansu. Modern-day Chinese people sometimes refer to themselves as the descendants of Yan and Yellow Emperor. Although non-Han minority groups in China may have their own myths or not count as descendants of the emperor, family and descendants according to the mausoleum of the Yellow Emperor in modern-day Shaanxi. The Yellow Emperor shares ancestry with that of a Central Plains race that went by the name Ji from their position along the Ji River. The Yellow Emperor's father was Shaodian and his mother was Fu Pao. The Yellow Emperor had a total of 4 wives. His first wife Li Zhiling bore him 2 sons. His other 3 wives were his second wife Feng Lai, third wife Tong Yu and fourth wife Momu. The emperor had a total of 25 sons, 14 of whom began their own surnames and clans. The oldest was Shao Ao or Shan Shao, who lived in Kunyang by the Yangtze River. Chang Yi, the younger, lived by the Ruo River. When the Yellow Emperor died, he was succeeded by Chang Yi's son, Duash. Later sources claim that several emperors and 3 subsequent dynasties descended from the Yellow Emperor. Other dynasties besides the first 3 also claimed descent from the Yellow Emperor. Emperors Duash, Ku, Yao, and Shun. Jia Dynasty, Shang Dynasty, Zhou Dynasty, Han Dynasty, Cao Wei, Song Dynasty. According to the Wei Xuan Tung Pa, the Cao family of Cao Wei were descended from Wang Di via Emperor Duash, from which the Cao family originated. They were of the same lineage as to Emperor Shun. Another account says that the Cao family was descended from Emperor Shun. This account was attacked by Chiang Kai, who claimed it was people of the Tian surname who were descended from Shun and not the Cao. He also claimed Kuo was Shun's family name. During the reign of Emperor Zhenzong Song, emperors claimed Huang Di as an ancestor. Guns, Yu, Duash, Zhong, Li, Shu Jun, and Yu Qiang are various emperors, gods, and heroes whose ancestor was Huang Di. The Wantu, Meme, and Quanrong peoples were said to be descended from Huang Di. Claims of descent during the Tang Dynasty. The Yellow Emperor, symbolic as the ancestor of the Han Chinese and founder of Chinese civilization, was also claimed by various other rulers who were not Han Chinese to be their ancestors, in order to connect themselves to the Tang. Prestige for the individual and status for their country was the goal of those non-Han who made claims of descent from these prominent Han figures. Claiming descent from Wang Di and the other 5 emperors was set during the Western Han Dynasty in Sima Qian's time. The claim that Shennong and Wang Di was ancestors of the Chinese was written about during Tang and Song. 14 out of 25 sons of Wang Di received 12 different family names. Shennong and Wang Di were regarded as the ancestor for the majority of Chinese surnames. The practice of Chinese claiming Wang Di as an ancestor was well established in Tang and Song China, with many Chinese families writing about their ancestry from Wang Di's sons and great-grandsons, Emperor Shun and Emperor Yao. Emperor Yao was also claimed to be the ancestor of the Han Dynasty Emperor Liu Bang. Most Chinese noble families claimed descent from Wang Di. Most Chinese genealogies trace their family ultimately to Wang Di. New families were founded by the younger sons of older families. When compared together, different Chinese genealogies frequently confirm these founding events by younger sons. Ling Pan claims that descent from Wang Di is commonly claimed by some overseas Chinese clans. Many Chinese clans in overseas areas will have genealogies displaying their descent from Wang Di, with their different surnames being explained by name changes. Wang Di granted 14 of his 25 sons different family names. These 14 family names are from which all other Chinese family names are traced to. Both many overseas Chinese and Chinese in China use genealogies which show the Wang Di as their ancestor to reinforce their being Chinese. In 1963, during the Qingming Festival, Huang Zhenduo wrote the genealogy of the Huang clan. He attacked the Taipings, Yuan Shikai, Chiang Kai-shek, the Japanese, and the Communists in the preface of his genealogy, all of whom virtually destroyed China and destroyed ancient historic genealogies of various Chinese families. He lamented the destruction and despaired at how people no longer knew their ancestors. The genealogist Huang Zhenduo claimed Huang Di's six generation descendants as the ancestors of the Huang lineage of the town Huangkun. Their surname Huang was derived from the Huang region, where they quarreled with each other. Various members of generations of the Huang family had important posts in government under King Wu of Zhou, under whom Huang Liangzi served, and the governor of Xin'an in 322 AD, was Huang Li of Huang Dun town. This town was near Huangkun. One of the Wangs had no children, so he adopted Cheng Qiwan, and Cheng Qiwan became Huang Qiwan and started the new Huang clan lineage from which the present-day Huang clan descended. The Yu family of Zhangwen village, Xinwei district, Guangdong claimed descent from Wang Di's son Shan Xio. Emperor Shun's agriculture minister, Duke Qi, was of one of the originally 15th generations of the family. The family adopted the last name Yu 30 generations after that. The kings of Qin and Jin honored their ancestor Yu Yu. Yu moved to Shandong. He was originally from the northern China plain. Another ancestor named Yu Rui moved near the Lo River in Shaanxi province. He became a center for the state of Qin. The family moved into Guangdong during the Ten Kingdoms and Five Dynasties.